On Thursday, 29 September, there was chaos at Parliament as members elected the EALA representatives. This followed claims by Aringa South Member of Parliament, Alion Odria, that there was vote rigging. Amid the scuffle, Odria punched one of the police officers, who was later identified as ASP Alex Senge. On Monday, police issued criminal summons for the legislator to appear at the Criminal Investigations Division on Tuesday, 4th October, and explain himself.
What is this?
However, Alion has been arraigned before Buganda Road Grade 1 Magistrate Sienna Womgisha and has been charged with assault and causing grievous harm to ASP Alex Senge. Alion has denied the charges before applying for bail, and court has granted him bail. He has been ordered to pay a cash bail of 1 million shillings, while his two securities, who include MPs Dennis Oguzu and John Baptist Loki, were each bonded 10 million non-cash. He was also asked to deposit his passport.
We know if he's granted bail, the way they have done, he will not be able to interfere with investigations. He will not pose any threat to the victims, so there was no cause of alarm that he should be denied bail.
And first of all, Alion is our colleague, he's a member of parliament like most of us. We believe even if it were you, when you see somebody playing with politics, playing with your election, what do you do? You don't just look on. We believe whatever he did, court will decide, but we had to come and stand with him.
And the MP will return to court on 4th November for trial since investigations are complete, as State Attorney Joanne Keto told court.
The fact that the offence is not of a grave nature, Your Worship, gravity of an offence is determined by so many things, not only the penalty, but also the effect of the offence to society. So the fact that this offence relates to attack on a police officer is grave enough in itself and should not be underscored by the applicant.
Relatedly, the Parliamentary Forum on Ethics and Integrity has come out to condemn gross misconduct of the Ringa South legislator, Alion Odria, who assaulted a police officer during the dramatic EALA elections last week and called for a full week training of members of parliament on ethics and integrity. This call has been made by the chairperson of the forum, who is also former Minister of Ethics, Nsaba Butoro, while speaking about the upcoming conference on ethics and morality slated for 15th November this year.
I think the speaker should be tough. Should be tough on those who clearly behave in a way that is dishonorable. How? By applying, we have clearly well laid out code of conduct that many of my colleagues, by the way, seem not to have read. They have no clue as to what exactly a member of parliament should look like, should behave like. They have no clue.
There you saw a member of parliament punching a police officer. Now, that's abnormal to say the least. You don't do it. But this person clearly doesn't see anything wrong with punching a police officer. He doesn't. I'm sure he went back thumping his chest that he had done it.
He now wants the Speaker of Parliament to organize a one-week training of members of Parliament on how they are supposed to behave, not only in Parliament, but also outside Parliament.
I would wish to see the Speaker giving us a whole week of training. The other day we did, I think, 1 or 2 days, and that wasn't enough. It wasn't even well attended, and some of those you see being cantankerous here, we are not in attendance. So that freedom to be do what you want is not befitting parliament. So
report by Fred Kajubi and Rachel Nachuala for the news.